Hey, in this one I'm gonna show you how you can detect memory leaks and other runtime errors that you can have in in any executable, but it's especially useful in C, C++, or like languages that manage memory manually, because you can forget to free a resource or access something you're not supposed to. So yeah, and the tool I use for this is valgrind, which you probably already know about, but I would like to make a more comprehensive review of it, and basically show all the thing you can use it for, or at least all the thing I use it for. So the basic example is, you can see I have a basic C file here ju with just a main. And if you have a pointer, let's say this, a new malloc, you have an allocation here, but you never free it. You compile it. And you will see that every time I compile, I use the dash G option to keep debugging information. That will be useful so that Valgrind can show us where the memory leak happened. It makes it a lot easier to debug. So you compile it and then you run just Valgrind on it. Up, and you can see that it said in use at exit 32 bytes. So it has detected that 32 bytes here have not been freed. And of course, if I don't have a memory leak, Valgrind doesn't show anything. And so the first thing we want to see is because just having an output like this is wait, let me recompile. Just having an output like this is not very useful because we don't know where. And so we want to add the flag leak check equal full, which in addition to the summary, it will also show each individual leak where it happened. So if you do this leak check full, yes, ah yes, it's here. Okay, it's so small. Usually you have a stack trace that is a bit larger than this, but as you can see, it prints a stack trace of where this happened, and so there is malloc and there is your main at line 6 where it happened. And as you can see, there is multiple categories of leaks. And so for this one, the very simple one, it's definitely lost. But there is also indirectly, possibly, and still reachable. And so as a rule of thumb, I think definitely lost and indirectly lost are the ones that are the most important. Still reachable are like, you still have a resource at the end of the program, but you didn't free it, but like, at the exit of the program, everything is freed anyway, so it's not too bad. And possibly lost is like, I'm not sure, but I think it's Valgrind is like unsure that it's lost or something. But I can show you, for example, the difference between definitely and indirectly lost. So let's say I allocate instead of this, I allocate a pointer of pointers, so a 2D array. And then I set the first. I don't know, let's say the first row of this to be also an allocation. And here, if I run this Valgrind on it, you can see that I have still 32 bytes of definitely lost, but I still have indirectly lost of 32 bytes because we have an allocation inside of an allocation and you only freed like the parent. And so that's why it said indirectly lost. And for I still have an example for still reachable, which is if you have a int p, let's say here, null. So if you have a static variable and you allocate it, I mean allocate some memory for it, and run it again, here it will show still reachable, so still reachable at the end of the program. And yeah, possibly lost, I'm not sure, but yeah, I would try to put all of those to zero if you can. And otherwise, it's sometimes when you use an external library. I know, for example, for when you use a SDL2, like the library itself doesn't clean everything properly, and so you have always a bit of leak. But yeah, try to not have them. So those are the different kinds of leaks. Then you can Valgrind can also detect like when you're reading or writing memory that you're not allowed to access. So for example, let's come back to this one and let's just make it a simple array. And let's say, I mean, let's just make it a sec fault actually. So let's actually let's keep the double pointer and do what I just did before. So this, okay, like this. So it's a double array, but I haven't allocated memory for the rows. And so I just don't have a memory at that space. And if I try to print P0, P0, of course, this doesn't exist, so it will sec fault. But actually, if you run Valgrind on this, it will, of course, it's a sec fault in this case, but it will also tell you invalid read of size 4. And if you try to write to it, it will also put, I think, an invalid write, like so. So still a sec fault, but here it's an invalid write because you write you wrote to something that doesn't belong to you. And here you might be wondering, like, okay, that's kind of cool. At least I know where my sec fault is happening. But it already crashes. So when this is useful is usually when you do. It's possible that you do an invalid read or write, but it doesn't actually sec fault. So you're accessing memory that you're not supposed to, but it's still fine from the OSS point of view, but it's like kind of undefined behavior, so you shouldn't do it. So this is quite handy to catch those as well. So next thing it can do is it can track if you forgot to close a file. So this one is rather simple, huh? If you have a file f... is equal to fopen, I don't know, let's see, hosts, why not? And you just forgot to close this. And you do this, okay, that of course does not work. I mean, it tells you that you have a leak, of course, because this is a struct that is a struct that is allocated. But it doesn't show you, you have to add an extra flag, which is track file descriptors, FDs, like so. And you have to say yes. And as you can see here, it tells you that you have forgot to close this file that was located here. So yeah, that's quite handy as well. Huh? And the last thing I use it for is so you can create children processes in any process, and by default Valgrind doesn't trace those, like Valgrind doesn't attach itself to those, and so you have to add an extra flag for it. But let's say I go back with my little malloc example, 32 bytes, like so. So if you run Valgrind like we did before, wait, if I don't forget to compile, and you run Valgrind like before, you can see that we have the leak. But what if you run a.out into another process? So what if you run it in a shell? So the shell will spawn or executable. Then, as you can see, there is no leak, but actually there was in this one. And so what you need to add as an argument for this one is trace children equals to yes. And actually, let me run that full screen, and you can see here, even though we are inside a child process, Valgrind detected that we have an error. So if you have a program that manages other programs and that calls, for example, exec VE or something like that to execute an external command, or I guess also the system, although you shouldn't use that, but if you use this kind of stuff to spawn another program, this is a useful argument to also trace if they have leaks. One other thing I forgot to mention is that if you work with uninitialized memory, Valgrind will detect it and warn it and send you a warning. So if you forgot to initialize a pointer or something, it's similar to invalid read Maybe not. But like, how could I demonstrate this? Maybe. Like so, and then I just try to use p, and int a is equal to this. Actually, not sure if that will work, but let's see. I mean, this will definitely seek fault, of course, but as I said before, it's not that it's not obvious all the time. Yeah, okay. So use the uninitialized value, as you can see. If you have well, something that you didn't set a value to, it will warn you if you use it. So yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Just checking my notes, and no, yeah, that's it. That's all the use case I ran into using Valgrind. I think it's a much more complex program than this, and you can do much more with it. I would recommend, I think they have a user guide, which I'm gonna, I guess, put in the description. Or you have just the man valgrind, of course. So yeah, I think you can have, check the cache or stuff, or do, you can have an output in a prettier format than in the terminal, I think, as well. Or it's compatible with other tools. Anyway. Yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. Hopefully it was a quick introduction to fixing memory leaks, and it helped you debug those, because without a tool like Valgrind, I have no clue how you would do it. I think I ran into a weird tool on macOS, but Valgrind is much better. So yeah, hope this helps, and see you in the next one.